right now, Charles Foti has come out. Everybody has had kind of put him down, but it looks like it's going to be a runoff, and he is approaching the stage right now. You heard earlier, a lot of people were calling this race for the incumbent, Marlon Gusman, but the camp here, the Foti camp, had refused to concede. They were not ready to throw in the towel, and as it turns out, at least as it appears right now, they were smart not to. Because at this point, it's either 48 or 49%, not 50 for Gusman. Let's go now to Charles Foti, the former sheriff, who is now at the mic getting a round of applause for squeaking into the runoff, apparently.
First of all, I'd like to say I am deeply humbled. I'm deeply humbled by this experience. The only regret that I have tonight is that my mother and father not here. You know, as you go through life, I made plenty of mistakes, but with the love of a great mother and a father that and a family that was behind me, I'd like to tell you to vote in public. Thank you very much. But this chance to help fix a jail that is in chaos and broken. During the coming weeks of this, we will discuss what is the future of the city of New Orleans and how it should best be served by its elected officials. To have a safe city, we have to have a safe jail. But more important is that what everybody forgot about is that we have young men and young women who have broken the law, that have come into the jail system. Their major problem is substance abuse, illegal drugs, and alcohol. We had an about-face program that turned that around. We put hundreds of people through there who went on to have successful and productive lives. What this is about is rehabbing people that have broken the law. Not only waiting until they come to jail, but doing what we did before with the young Marines, the junior deputies, and after-school programs for at-risk youth that have been flunked out of school or thrown out of school. And with volunteers from both Tulane and LSU Medical School, we helped to turn these lives around. The About Face program taught them discipline. The therapeutic drug community taught them how to live with their problem and how to overcome. And once you do that, then you start with adult basic education and literacy courses. And you know, the sheriff's office is not just an office. It's a community resource. It is a resource by which we serve the community. If you remember, during the time I was sheriff, we painted every school in the city of New Orleans. We cleaned the streets. We work with the neighborhoods to clean the neighborhoods. We worked the city of New Orleans to clean the catch basins. We did this for two reasons. One is to show that we were partners with the community. Two is to let the inmates experience a work experience and feel the gratitude of people that they have served. And we served the seniors. We started the Thanksgiving program, and every holiday, when Meals on Wheels did not deliver, we delivered food with volunteers to their homes. And what we did for the kids, besides the schooling programs, when Halloween was in desperate straits because you could not think about letting your kid go out in the street because of all the bad things were happening, we started in Witt City Park a program to have something for the whole family to enjoy. We partnered with City Park. We kept City Park alive. You can go back and say, high school athletics, when they repaired and renovated Tag Army Stadium, we were there. When Pan American Stadium, I signed the lease with City Park to run, renovate, and keep in good shape Pan American Stadium. When the Children's Museum was being built, they didn't have any money. We used inmates to do that. So inmates are a resource to the community. And by doing that, you have a resource for themselves to show that they can do worthwhile work and be forgiven. And what we bring back is what they call restorative justice. Restorative justice is where the victim is willing, they can talk with the inmates so they can show them the harm that was caused in their lives, and they can come to closure by that. So what I say to you is that this is a dawn of a new age. We came in this race as an underdog. We have not had a race in 8 years. What did we do? We went and told our message. You know, it is funny that over all of this time, 10 years later, I'm being blamed for things that happened. But let's get it straight. The constitutional issues that the federal courts said they violated were operational issues. It is how they treated the inmates. Well, it made the inmates worse than when they came in. Maybe having guns in jail is not important to some people. Maybe smoking crack in jail is not important to some people. Maybe not seeing it is important. Maybe if you shut your eyes, it goes away. But nothing really goes away. If we don't address a problem, it becomes worse. Thank you very much. Without their support, I wouldn't be here today. And some people, and I have to end it with this, some people ask why I wanted to run again. Because of the passion for the men and women that work in that office, because of the disgrace that office has become, because they are good men and women, they just need leadership, and God willing, and the voters willing, we will provide that leadership to make this a great office in a great city with great people. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, all excitement. I wouldn't be here, but I have to say this, that I became a partner. Why, can I have your attention just for 1 minute? I became a partner at Kime, Swift, and Foti. I think that some of the days during the race that my partners thought that what did they let themselves in for? And I want to thank them for their support and everything that they did for me and for all of you that gave up your time and effort. You know, this is all volunteers in this room. Nobody had a job to keep. Nobody had anything but to say, how can we make this a better city?
There you go. So, Charlie, what... There you go. Just stand right there. So, you know, people kind of gave you up early, just a little bit earlier this evening. Some people were calling this race, saying that it was over. You kind of resurrected yourself one more time.
Never give up on Foti. No. If you have a passion and you believe and you thank the good Lord, you ask the good Lord, what should I do? And he sort of indicated this is what he wanted me to do. And you want to spend the rest of your life trying to help people and make them better and make this a better place and save some people's lives. You know, if you look at the statistics here, UNO's voter deal said that 62% were still worried about crime, whether actual crime or the perception of crime. So we want to help bring that down, work with the city, work with the people and neighborhood groups to do it.
For a time tonight, did you think you would not make it because you stayed out of here? You didn't come out until you were certain.
Well, I didn't want to just come out and just talk with people. I wanted to see what was happening. I had confidence I had the belief that we would make it, that our message was resonating, and we tried.
Give us a glimpse of the type of campaign you will run for the runoff.
I think we'll talk about issues. We'll talk about what has happened, what has happened, what can happen, and what should happen.
Charlie, you started campaigning, it sounded like, from the podium. You already were in the runoff from up there.
Well, you know, I feel strongly about this issue. I feel strongly about that jail should be run right. I feel strongly about that the men and women that work there are getting a bad knock.
All right.
And so I'm going to do the best I can to make their life worthwhile, but also to make the life of the average citizen worthwhile, too.
Charlie Foti, congratulations for making the runoff. Thank you very, very much. Charlie Foti giving up a little bit earlier this evening. A lot of people were calling the race for incumbent Marlon Gusman, but as the numbers are counted, as all of the numbers are in, there is indeed a runoff, either 48-49% for Marlon Gusman, but it's still not over the top. And Charlie Foti is in a runoff with Marlon Gusman for Orleans Parish Sheriff. For now, we'll give it back to you.